Hi, this is Julie Harland. Please visit my website, youremathgal.com, where all my videos are organized by topic. So in this video, I'm going to do a few examples showing how to add rational expressions, which really means we're just adding fractions. And in order to add fractions, you have to have a common denominator. So here's our first example, 4 over x minus 4 plus 3 over 2x plus 1. Now notice, I've left some space between the first fraction and the plus sign over here. And the reason is because I do not have a common denominator, so I'm going to have to multiply the numerator and denominator by something to make an equivalent fraction. So the first thing to notice here, 4 over x minus 4, is that x minus 4 is the denominator. X is not a factor. 4 is not a factor. It's this entire expression, x minus 4. Same thing over here, the second fraction, 2x plus 1 is the denominator. There's only one factor in each fraction. So there's a lot of ways people figure out how to get the least common denominator, but if you have two fractions and each of them only have a single factor in the denominator and they're not the same, basically you're going to have to multiply those together to get your common denominator. So that means in this first fraction, let's see, I also need a factor of 2x plus 1, so I need to multiply this numerator and denominator by the 2x plus 1. And for the second fraction, I need to have the same denominator I have over here, which is x minus 4 times 2x plus 1, so I need to multiply it by x minus 4. So what I'm doing is creating a common denominator. Now here's where a lot of people get tripped up. The reason we're doing this is so that we keep this denominator of x minus 4 times x plus 1. So we want to leave that in factored form, but in the numerator, you need to do that multiplication. So in this first fraction, you have to do 4 times 2x plus 1, and if you do the distributive property, 4 times 2x is 8x, plus 4 times 1 is 1, and you want to just keep your denominator in the factored form. Oops. 2x plus 1. And I need to do the same thing over here. You know, just write my denominator. And remember to multiply the 3 times the x minus 4. So again, I'm going to do my distributive property to get 3x minus 12. Now we just keep the denominator. Once it's the same, that means we have to add the numerators. So that means we can put this all over one denominator, which is the same, x minus 4 times 2x plus 1. And in the numerator, notice I simplified each of the numerators, so it's going to be easy to add those together. And I'm going to write out that step, 8x plus 4 plus 3x minus 12. Some people do that addition in their head, but I am going to show all steps in this problem. So my denominator is still x minus 4 times, oops, this is a 2x plus 1. And in the numerator, adding like terms gives me 11x minus 8. The last thing you would do is see if you could factor the numerator and see if anything cancels. But again, the numerator is 11x minus 8. That can't be factored. So usually we just leave our answers like this with the denominator factor. But if you'd prefer, you can say that's the same thing as, well, if you do the Boyle method here, we're going to have 2x squared. See, the outer term is plus x, and the one is the middle term, the inner term is negative 8x. That gives you negative 7x. And then negative 4 times 1 is negative 4. That's okay to write it like that as well. But if you do that, remember, if you couldn't cancel it when it was over what I'm showing you in the first box, you're not going to be able to cancel it over the second way. Don't try to cancel the 8 with a 4. Okay? Cannot do that. 4 is not a factor. 8 is not a factor. All right, here's another example. We're going to start the same way. We notice that each of these fractions only have one factor, which And the first one is x plus 8, and the second one is x 3x minus 2. So I'm going to have to multiply the first fraction by 3x minus 2, so it also has that factor in the denominator. And the second fraction I'll have to multiply by x plus 8. So that now you see that both of the fractions have this common denominator, x plus 8 over 3x minus 2. Okay, I'm going to do a little bit of a shortcut from the last one. Instead of writing each of these fractions separately, I know since they have a common denominator, my final answer will have that denominator, x plus 8 times 3x minus 2. Okay? And what do I do, though, with the numerator? So I'm going to concentrate on the numerator. I need to simplify this first fraction by doing the distributive property, x times 3x minus 2, plus I also have to distribute the 5 to the x plus 8. Keep in mind, nothing is going to cancel. That would be going backwards. So we have x times 3x minus 2, that's 3x squared minus 2x. And plus, now I've got to do the 5 times the x plus 8. 5x plus 40. What confuses a lot of people is if they didn't distribute on this very first step and they wrote x times 3x minus 2, they tried canceling the 3x minus 2s. So make sure you do that distributive property right away. Okay, so almost done actually. Now I'm going to just combine the like terms in the numerator. So I have 3x squared plus 3x plus 40. And I'm going to leave my denominator factor for now. And the last thing you do is see if it's possible to factor the numerator, but this does not factor. So this is the answer. But again, if you'd like, you could multiply out the denominator. If you do, just remember you're still not going to be able to cancel anything. If it doesn't cancel anything in factored form, it's not going to cancel it after you multiply those denominators together. Right, here is our next example. So again, I notice that each denominator has only one factor. So I'm going to have to multiply this first fraction by the denominator I have over here, 5x minus 1. And of course, we do that with the numerator and denominator. And the second fraction needs to be multiplied by x plus 4 over x plus 4. And so I know what my common denominator is, so I know I'm going to eventually get this all over 1 denominator of 5x minus 1 times x plus 4. The order of the two factors doesn't matter. That's up to you. Now, the new numerator, before I could add these together, you know, order of operation, I got to do this multiplication, the 5x times the 5x minus 1. So that's going to give me 25x squared minus 5x. And I also have to do 2x times x plus 4. So that's going to be 2x squared plus 8x. And now I need to combine like terms. The denominator, just keep writing the denominator down. So if I add like terms, I have 27x squared plus 3x. Okay. Now, this numerator does factor. I could factor out a 3x. And have a 9x plus 1. But you'll notice that that is not going to cancel with either of these factors in the denominator. So as far as the best way to leave your answer, well, that actually depends. These are both actually okay. Some teacher might tell you to simplify both the numerator and denominator by multiplying them out. And others might say leave in factored form. So So you notice this first way I put a box around it, the numerator is not factored, but the denominator is. The second way I've done it, the numerator is factored and the denominator is factored. And then of course, a third way is you could have written it like this. You could have also had nothing factored for your final answer. By multiplying 5x minus 1 times x plus 4, which is 5x squared. And I'm going to have 20 minus 1x, that's 19x, minus 4. These are all equivalent answers. Alright, let's do one more. So again, we have just one factor in the first fraction, one factor in the second fraction. So I need to multiply the first fraction times x plus 8 over x plus 8. Which we're going to put a parentheses around this 3x plus 5. Because you don't get to just multiply the 5 times it. You have to take the whole numerator, which is 3x plus 5, and multiply by x plus 8. And the second fraction will have to multiply numerator and denominator by x minus 8 over x minus 8. Now, this little shortcut I've shown you where you could just write the denominator once under a big fraction is not so simple to do if there's a minus sign here. The reason this works out more easily is because I have a plus sign. If you have a minus, you'd really want to multiply this top out and then you'd have to distribute your minus sign. So it's a little more involved. So just be careful. Alright, so in the first fraction, I need to multiply out the 3x plus 5 times x plus 8. Let's see, that's going to be a 3x squared. Let's see, I'm going to have 24 plus 5x, that's going to be 29x, plus 40. And since it's a plus, this is good. If this was a minus, the next part where I would have to put in parentheses, and then I would have to combine like terms. So I'm just going to put the parentheses here just so you see that if it was a minus sign, there would be a little bit of distributing going on. But I don't have one, so this is still just x squared. Minus 8x minus 9x is going to be minus 17x and plus 72. But since it's a plus, I really can just add like terms at this point. So what do I have? I still have this denominator, x minus 8 times x plus 8. And I've got 3x squared plus 1x squared, that's a 4x squared, because I didn't need such a big fraction bar. 29x minus 17x, so what is that? That is 12x, right? And then I have 40 plus 72, that's 112. Now, notice I can factor the numerator. There's a common factor of 4. So I could factor a 4 out, which gives me x squared plus 3x plus 28, and then I would see if this factors, but it doesn't. And there's one way to write the answer. You could see there are no common factors. On the other hand, you can go ahead and instead of writing these in factored form, you can go right back up to what you have before. 4x squared plus 12x plus 112, and in the denominator, that's the difference of t squares, x squared, minus 64. So those are equivalent expressions, one where it's factored in the numerator and denominator, one where it's not. But both of those, in a way, can be considered the same answer. Some teachers might want you to leave it in factored form, and some would want you to multiply them out, but they are equivalent to each other. All right, so there's four examples. Adding. It is slightly more complicated when you have a minus sign, so be careful and see my other videos for that.